Yes, sister.
Yeah.
She has a question?
She has a question, yes.
Yes, sister, most welcome.
Good evening, Dr. Nayak.
Good evening.
My name is Perin Abbas. I am born in a Muslim family, but not a practicing Muslim. Because I don't understand what I'm supposed to do. So my profession is that of a management trainer and a life coach. My question for you today is, I see a lot of Muslims around me, they follow the religion because of fear. Fear of Allah, fear of going to hell. And my question to you is that shouldn't this be based on motivation to do the right thing as opposed to fear of burning in hell or roasting in hell, as I've seen in some of your other lectures.
Sister, so, asked.
Yeah.
Yes, is anything else?
No, this is it. Thank you.
Sister asked a very good question. That she sees around, she said that she's born in a Muslim family, not a practicing Muslim. Inshallah, we pray that she becomes practicing from today, inshallah.
Dr. Zafar, there's another woman. She's also Christian.
Sorry?
We have another lady, she is Christian.
After, let me answer the question first.
Sure.
The sister said that she sees around the Muslims that many a time they follow the teachings of Islam because of fear. So shouldn't it be, fear is not right, it should be love. Why people, you know, follow because of fear? Sister, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives guidance in the Quran. And while giving guidance, He gets people to the straight path in three ways. With fear, with love, and with logic. Depending upon the requirement, the best is love. Even logic is very good, alhamdulillah. Even fear is good, depending upon the situation. Sister, I would like to ask you a question. Suppose, are you married?
No, I'm not.
Okay. Maybe your younger brother. Fine? Younger brother who's 5 years old, hypothetically. He wants to jump from the 10th floor. You tell with love, no brother, don't jump. He yet wants to jump. What will you do? Will you slap him or not?
Yes.
When you slap him, he gets scared. He will not jump. I will tell, oh sister, you are a terrorist. You are making your younger brother scared. See, first you tried with love, he's not listening to you. You slap him, he gets scared, he doesn't jump. Your reason was, you are cruel to be kind. You are cruel to be kind. You slap him because he is illogical. He doesn't understand the matter with love. Because if he jumps, he will die. So to prevent him from dying, you are slapping him. He gets scared, he benefits. You may or may not benefit, but he's benefiting. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, he speaks with love. He speaks with logic. He even puts sometimes fear. So then he also attracts people with Jannah. That if you do good deeds, you go to Jannah. Love each other. Help your neighbors. When you're helping others, so all these things, one is reason and logic. One is fear, one is love. Fear is also a factor which does really help a lot, because those who are not logical and those who don't believe in love, fear helps. And once, when they try following with fear, once he becomes the adult, then he doesn't require fear. Then logically he will not jump. Correct, sister?
Correct. The thing that children are brought up, at least I've been brought up with, mainly fear of Allah. So it's generally to do with, if you don't do it, this is going to happen. So there was less
that the people who brought you up did not bring you up in the right way. But now they won't be responsible. You will be responsible because you're an adult, sister. Now you're an adult. You cannot say because the people who brought me up, because they brought me up with fear, no, I'm not a practicing Muslim. Allah will question you. Now you heard the lecture of Quran and science. Was there any fear in it?
No.
Yes, the last statement did say about the pain receptors, but that was scientific. Fear was involved in it, but it was scientific. What I'm asking you, after you heard this lecture, don't you think Quran should be followed?
Yes.
So now you have no excuse. You had excuse till yesterday. Till yesterday you could say that the people who bought me, they bought me up with fear, therefore I'm not a practicing Muslim. Now when you heard a logical your lecture, and there's a question answer time, that what you feel is not right in Islam, you can question. After this, you will not have an excuse that why you're not following Islam. So everything has a reason and logic. Fear is one factor which may be used for those people who are illogical or less in sense. So that may be temporary, sister. Now surely that after you have heard this lecture, which is based on reason and logic and science, you have no excuse for not following Islam. And anything what you don't know, the Quran says, ask the person who knows. So anything you think about Islam, that fine, Islam says that It may say that you have to fast. If you don't fast, you go to hell. You can ask a scientific person, I can give a talk on scientific talk on what is the benefit of fasting. So those people who don't understand reason and logic, they may get convinced for fear. Some people may say, when you fast, you go to Jannah. So there are different strategies used by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is our creator. He knows what is required and how do we behave. So based on that, fear many a times is helpful in getting a person on the straight path. But the moment the fear is removed, that person should stand on his own feet and be able to do the things correctly, not because of fear. Finally, it is because of love and because of reason and logic that he wants to go to Jannah and he wants to benefit sister. So I hope, inshallah, from today you'll be practicing Muslim, inshallah, sister.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yes, sister, most welcome.